Hello friends, in today's lecture we are going to see in detail DNA fingerprinting. So DNA fingerprinting is a laboratory technique which is used to establish a link between the biological evidence and the suspect in the criminal investigation. But simply, DNA fingerprinting is a technique by which we can found the relationship between the biological evidence and the suspect which is in the criminal investigation. And the DNA sample which is taken from a crime scene, it's compared with a DNA sample from a suspect. Means simply, at the crime scene we will get the blood stains, the cloth on which the blood stains will be there, hairs, nails, skin part and so on. So these are the samples, and these samples are taken from the crime scene, and that can be compared with the DNA sample of the suspect. If the two DNA profiles were matched, then the evidence came from that suspect. Means when DNA will be matched of the sample which is obtained at the crime scene and the suspect. So when both things were matched, obviously the victim and suspect are correlated and their suspect is involved in the crime. And this DNA fingerprinting technology has made it is possible to identify the source of biological samples found at scenes of crime, and this will resolve the disputes of maternity, paternity, that means the child is of this parent only or the biological father or biological mother, that can be checked. This is called as a maternity and the paternity test. Then identification of the mutilated remains, identification of rape cases, murders, identification of missing child, exchange of babies in the hospital wards, forensic wildlife, protection of farmers' rights and biodiversity. These are the remarkable technology advantages. And this technology provides exclusion as well as positive identification with virtually 100% precision. Means simply, DNA fingerprinting technique has a wide uses. It is useful for paternity, maternity tests, then for identification of the mutilated remains, for identification of the suspect in the rape case and the murder case, then for identification of the child which was missed or the missing child. Then when rarely there is exchange of babies which occurs in the hospital wards, then that time paternity maternity test or the DNA fingerprinting plays an important role. And history of DNA fingerprinting. So up to 1984, there is only one method was established, and this is useful for authenticating personal identification. And the process is the fingerprint process. And DNA fingerprinting technique was devised in 1985 by the scientist Alec Jaffrey at the University of Leicester in England. So Alec Jaffrey is a father of DNA fingerprinting, and while working on the sequences within the myoglobin gene. This is the photo of Alec Jaffrey, who is the father of DNA fingerprinting in the whole world, who developed the DNA fingerprinting technique in 1985. And the process of DNA fingerprinting was invented by the Alec Jeffries at the University of Leicester 1985 in, and he was knighted in 1994. And DNA fingerprinting or the DNA profiling, in the previous one lecture we have seen what is meant by DNA profiling and the methods like STR, PCR and so on. So simply DNA fingerprinting and the DNA profiling can be analyzed by using similar techniques. So simply any of several similar techniques for analyzing and comparing DNA from separate sources, used especially in law enforcement to identify suspects from human hair, blood of the suspect, semen or other biological materials found at the scene of a violent crime. So simply for identification of DNA fingerprinting and DNA profiling, we require here blood, semen or other biological materials. And it depends on the fact that no two people save identical twins. So as we know, the each and every person has a different fingerprint, a separate fingerprint, or this is the unique identity of that person. So when there are two people, though the people are the twins, but their DNA fingerprint does not match. And biological material that is useful for the DNA analysis by using DNA fingerprinting technique are, first one is the hair, second is the skin, third one is semen, and last one is the blood. So we have again seen how blood can be analyzed from alcohol, or sorry, we have seen how alcohol is analyzed from the blood by using gas chromatography and the IR spectroscopy. So here are the stages which are involved in the DNA fingerprinting. So firstly, we have to collect the DNA sample from the crime scene. Then there is extraction of the DNA strands. These DNA strands will be cut into smaller DNA strands by using the restriction enzymes. This is our second step. And after that, these strands will be transferred into the electrophoresis technique. So by using electrophoresis technique, the separation will be done. And here the short DNA fragments and long DNA fragments were observed. Then from electrophoresis, this sample can be transferred to the membrane. And here we will get the longer fragments and the shorter fragments. Then there is a fifth step where incubation with labeled probes, these strands, DNA strands, here one side is labeled and that can be useful for the separation of the strands. And lastly, by using X-ray, we will get the DNA fingerprint. So these are the steps. First is a collection of the DNA sample, then extraction of sample. Then we will get DNA segment or the DNA fragments. Then this can be cut into small one by using restriction enzymes. These smaller ones can be labeled and then transferred to the electrophoresis technique. Then this can be transferred to the membrane and then incubation. And after that, the X-rays were bombarded on it and we will get a DNA fingerprint. So these are the steps involved in the DNA fingerprinting. And DNA strands cuts into smaller fragments, then fragments are separated, then pattern of fragments are analyzed. So here are the DNA fingerprinting methods. So a common procedure for DNA fingerprinting is the restriction fragment length polymorphism. We have seen this method in the one lecture, RFLP, that is a restriction fragment length polymorphism. And in this method, the DNA is extracted from a sample and then cut it into smaller pieces or the smaller segments by using the restriction enzymes. This RFLP, that is a restriction fragment length polymorphism, focuses on contained sequences of repeated DNA bases and which vary widely from person to person. And the segments are separated using a laboratory technique which is known as electrophoresis, and which sorts the fragments by length, the shorter length DNA fragments and the longer length DNA fragments that can be separated by using electrophoresis technique. Then the segments are radioactively tagged, that means labeled, to produce a visual pattern known as a autoradiograph. So simply labeled segments are used to produce a visual pattern which is known as autoradiograph or the DNA fingerprint or X-ray film. And a newer method known as the short tandem repeats, that is the STR, which analyzes DNA segments for the number of repeats at 13 specific DNA sites. And the chance of misidentification in this procedure is 1 in several billions. Means this STR technique is more accurate and the exact technique. And 8 another procedure is there. Means firstly we have seen RFLP, second one is the STR technique, and last one is the, again very important, that is a PCR. So nowadays we have seen the RT-PCR. So RT-PCR test is useful for the testing COVID-19. So same method which is called as a PCR, polymerase chain reaction, and this can be useful for DNA fingerprinting analysis. So simply, PCR technique is used to produce multiple copies of segments of DNA from a very limited amount of DNA. It's at least 50 molecules of DNA initially we have taken, and then it cut it into the small segments, and these are around 50. And enabling a DNA fingerprint to be made from a pattern of the alleles. Alleles, this word is from the genetics, and from a limited number of genes, it is compared with the pattern from the reference sample. Means simply, in the PCR technique, this PCR technique is used to produce the multiple copies of segments from a very limited amount of a DNA. At least 50 copies or the 50 molecules of the DNA will be produced by using PCR, and enabling a DNA fingerprint to be made from a single hair. And once a sufficient sample has been produced, the pattern of the alleles from a limited number of genes that can be compared with a standard or the reference pattern of a sample or the reference, and if there is a non-match, it's conclusive, but the technique provides little certainty when a match occurs. So, RFLP, STR, that is a short tandem repeats, and the PCR, these are the three techniques which are useful for the DNA fingerprinting. And DNA fingerprinting applications. DNA fingerprinting can be applied in the following scenarios: establishment of paternity and the maternity test, establishment of the parentage for the child swapping cases in the hospitals, then establish the identity of the rapist in the rape cases, then identification of the mutilated remains in the murder, bomb blast, ear crashes, etc. Then wildlife identification, species identification, and the seed authentication in the agri. So these are the main applications of the DNA fingerprinting. And here is the how was the first DNA fingerprint produced. So the first step of DNA fingerprinting was the extraction of the DNA from a sample of human material. Usually it is collected from the blood. Then molecular scissors, which are called as a restriction enzymes. This is our second step by which we can cut DNA into small fragments. So this restriction enzymes can cut the DNA into small fragments, which can result into the thousands of pieces of DNA with the variety of different lengths. Then these pieces of DNA were separated according to their size or length, either short or long, on the gel electrophoresis. Then the DNA was loaded into wells at one end of a porous gel, which acted a bit like a sieve. And an electric current was applied by which pulled the negatively charged DNA through the gel, and the shorter pieces of DNA moved through the gel by the easier way, and therefore the rate of its separation is the faster. So simply shorter pieces of DNA will be easily get separated through the gel, and it is more difficult for the longer pieces of DNA to move through the gel, so they traveled very slowly. And as a result, by the time the electric current was switched off and the DNA pieces had been separated in order of size, initially smaller size or the shorter length DNA fragments were collected, then the larger size DNA fragments were collected. And once the DNA had been sorted according to their size, the pieces of DNA were then transferred to the or blotted out of the fragile gel onto a robust piece of nylon membrane. Means after separation, this DNA fragments will be transferred to the nylon membrane and then unzipped to produce the single strands of DNA. And next, the nylon membrane was incubated with the radioactive probes. And here, probes are these small fragments of the mini satellite DNA tagged with radioactive phosphorus. So simply, the nylon membrane was incubated with the radioactive probes, which contains the radioactive phosphorus. And the probes only attach to the pieces of DNA that they are complementary to, and in this case they attach to the mini satellites in the genome. And the mini satellites that the probes have attached to were then visualized by exposing the nylon membrane to the X-ray film. And when this nylon membrane is exposed to the X-ray film, we will get image. And when exposed to radioactivity, a pattern of more than 30 dark bands appeared on the X-ray film where the labeled DNA was present, and this pattern was the DNA fingerprint. And to compare two or more different DNA fingerprints, the different DNA samples were run side by side on the gel electrophoresis, and we will get the separated DNA fragments that will be transferred to the nylon membrane, then to the X-ray film, and we will get a DNA fingerprint. And lastly, we have again seen the DNA profiling. So in modern day, DNA fingerprinting is also called as a DNA profiling, and this is also known as a STR analysis, PCR analysis, REF, LP analysis. So microsatellites, or the short tandem repeats, are the shorter relatives of Many satellites, usually 2 to 5 best pairs are present. So many satellites, they are repeated many times throughout the human genome. For example, TATATATA. So this repeating units are called as a many satellites. And we have seen this DNA profiling, DNA polymorphism, its types, then DNA typing procedures, IFLP, PCR and STR. Same procedures you can use in detail for the DNA fingerprinting. So here are the three methods. RFLP, which we have seen in detail in one lecture. Then VNTR or STR method, and last one is the PCR method. So you can refer this DNA profiling lecture for further study of DNA fingerprinting.